Today is the 20-year anniversary of Hurricane Isabel hitting Maryland.
Yeah, it's hard to believe it's already been 20 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you guys are way too young to remember anything that happened 20 years ago, of course.
Yeah.
Come on, you
Nice.
Thank
try.
You, though. Thank you, though.
It was a pretty wild couple of days here in Maryland. We had a storm surge up the bay that was like 5 to 8 feet. Mm-hmm. There were tornadoes. There were wind gusts up to 70, 80 miles per hour. Now, Mindy, you were here in 2003. Yeah. Do you have any memories of that?
Oh, gosh. It's the canoes in downtown.
Right. People
Baltimore.
Going around in canoes.
People in canoes.
It's nuts. Yeah. So here's a couple of still images from that storm. In the upper right, that's what it looked like in downtown Baltimore right there. In the lower left, that was Annapolis, and we caught somebody getting around in a canoe in that picture right there. And the lower right is Kent Narrows over on the eastern shore. There was big flooding there over on the eastern shore. So how do you get a big storm surge to come up the Chesapeake Bay? The storm track has to go west of Baltimore because you have the counterclockwise circulation around the storm. So when the storm takes this kind of a path like Isabel did coming up out of Virginia into western Maryland, it just grabs all of that water off of the Atlantic and pushes it up the bay. And that's how you wind up with a 5 to 8 foot storm surge. Now, fortunately for us, there aren't a lot of storms that take this exact path. When the storm path goes east of us, this doesn't happen. Or if it goes a little further west, it doesn't have the same effect. But Isabel had that perfect track. It was just far enough to the west to grab all that water and push it up the bay. So we did have some tornadoes and wind gusts, 70, 80 miles per hour, but there wasn't a lot of heavy rain with Isabel. This is a plot of the rainfall from that event. And this bright orange and red down here represents 7 to 8 inches. That was mostly down southern Maryland and the lower eastern shore around Baltimore. We picked up anywhere from 2 to 4 inches of rain, which is a lot, but not as much as it could have been. It was a significant event here in Baltimore, to say the least, 20 years ago today. And of course, Chief Meteorologist Tom Tassemeyer was here for that. Tom, what are your memories of Isabel on that day?
I'm with the anchor desk over there, just remembering people floating, boating down Pratt Street. I mean, that's certainly was shocking, to say the least, no doubt about it. And the winds, too, were pretty significant around here. We did get the floods, as you mentioned, Tony, from the surge and not really from the rain.